just how good is Hasbro's new Spengler Neutrono wand? Well, join us today as we compare it against some previous release Ghostbusters wands and see if this one is worth the hype. Hey everybody, Jason here of GhostbustersNews.com, and as always, Ghostbusters News right here on YouTube, and today I'm back again talking about Hasbro's brand new Spengler Neutrono wand. Now, if you didn't check out our previous video on the Hasbro Spengler Neutrono wand, I certainly suggest you do. We have a link to that video right down below in the description. We go into detail about all the features of the wand, we also compare it to the Ghostbusters Afterlife screen-used wand, and we also have an interview with Ghostbusters Afterlife armorer Ben Eady. It is a packed episode of Ghostbusters News, and if you haven't checked it out, certainly do so. Once again, link can be found right down below in that description. But since the release of that video, I've had tons of people messaging me, emailing me, being like, Jason, can you make a video where you compare the Hasbro wand against some other popular released Ghostbusters Neutrono wands? And you know, I'm here for you guys, so that is exactly what we're going to be doing today. Let's actually break everything out on the table right now and show you what we're going to be doing exactly. From left to right, we have got the wand typically found at Halloween stores, including Spirit Halloween, which that guy is usually attached to a proton pack, so of course, that's the big selling point for that wand. After that, we've got this wand here, which we all know and love. It was previously released via MattyCollector.com back in 2013. And to the right of that, we've got the brand new Spengler Neutrono wand made by Hasbro, available via HasbroPulse.com. Now, I think for the bulk of this video, the real comparison is going to be between the Spengler Neutrono wand, once again made by Hasbro, and once again, the wand that was sold back in 2013 by MattyCollector.com. I mean, these wands are pretty darn similar, at least in terms of like sizing and such, and you know, features and everything. The wand that's part of the Halloween costume, once again, that you can typically buy at like Spirit Halloween locations and Halloween stores, to me, that wand is an afterthought. Really, the big selling point of that is the proton pack that it's attached to. But you guys wanted a comparison, and of course, I am going to oblige. So let's do a direct comparison right now between that Halloween store-based wand and the Hasbro Spengler Neutrono wand. Now, the first thing you're going to notice is obviously the scale difference here. The Halloween store-based wand has certainly been scaled down. I mean, it's pretty darn tiny. Well, with the Hasbro wand, it's pretty much true to scale. And I gotta be honest here, I really don't think this is a fair comparison between these two, but once again, you guys asked for it. As you can see also with the Hasbro wand, there is a ton of buttons on it, and we're gonna get to all those buttons here in a minute there when we compare it up against the wand that was previously sold via MattyCollector.com. But comparing it to the Halloween store wand, there's not too much going on here when it comes to like operational buttons. Really, there's one here, it's right here, you hit it. And that's what you get. You get some audio coming from the proton pack. You get the light sequence here, a little light on the side, and that's about it. So yeah, it's really not a fair fight here comparing these two wands here. I mean, this is definitely more so for a collector. I'm not saying the Halloween store wand like isn't for collectors, because you know, I obviously have one and I like to collect. But for a lot of people out there that actually like, you know, use the proton pack and they modify the proton pack and they trick it out and they wear it to like conventions and such like that, usually this wand here gets replaced by, you know, something that's a little bit better looking. And I think for a lot of people going forward, this wand, the Halloween store-based wand, is going to get replaced by the Hasbro wand. In fact, I think one of the biggest reasons probably a lot of people out there ask me to compare the Hasbro wand up against the Halloween store wand is they want to see a comparison of this wand next to the Halloween store pack. So this is how they look next to each other in terms of scale, in terms of coloring. And for the Halloween store pack here, I've not modified it in any way. Like, this is straight out of the box. And I'm sure as we near that March 2021 release, as we get more photos from, you know, the Ghostbusters Afterlife set, and we get more trailers and videos and such like that, we're gonna see people modify their Halloween store proton packs to match, you know, the Afterlife style packs a bit more. And once again, this is gonna make a great, great, great accessory piece for those people with the Halloween store packs. All right, so now that we got that out of the way, let's go on to the main event here as we compare, once again, the Hasbro Spengler Neutrono wand up against the wand previously sold by MattyCollector.com back in 2013. And let me say, for the one released back in 2013, I mean, I love this thing. I think it looks great for what it was, for its time and such like that. It does do a great job at kind of replicating that that original proton wand, neutrono wand from 1984, like the original Ghostbusters film. It looks great for what it is. And this was really one of the first adult replica toys we actually saw ever released from Ghostbusters. So when it came out back in 2013, like, it did blow fans' minds. Like, I remember like running around the house with this thing like all hours of the day, just, you know, blasting ghosts everywhere. Now, since 2013, this neutrono wand has like skyrocketed in price. When it was first available, it was $129.99. Since then, it's not too uncommon to actually buy this like in box for like triple the price point. And from what I gather, triple the price is like best case scenario. A lot of the times, these will go for much, much higher. And that is why I, and I'm sure a lot of other fans out there, are like elated that once again, Hasbro is like the master toy licensee for Ghostbusters now. And we got this boy right here. So we've got the two ones next to one another right now. And obviously the big change up when you first see them is the one that was released back in 2013. It's based off of the original two Ghostbusters films. Well, Hasbro's release is based off of next year's Ghostbusters Afterlife film. All right, now that we've got both of these side by side here, I do actually want to give you my first impressions when I took the Hasbro one out of the box. I mean, first thing was first was like the use of metal. Like the metal switches here really caught my eye and really helped make it feel a little more like a prop or like a prop replica rather than a toy. And the metal doesn't stop there. There's like tons of areas on this one that's actually using metal rather than plastic. And that's actually a really, really good thing that metal is being used for a lot of these pieces, because I actually want to bring in and do a quick comparison once again of the previously released wand here, because there was quite a few areas that were actually like a black plastic that were painted silver to look like metal. And now that I've had this thing for like 6 or 7 years, you can see some of that paint has actually rubbed off in those areas. With the Hasbro wand using metal in these locations, you're not going to have that problem. There's really nothing to like rub off or anything like that when it comes to the metal pieces, because once again, it is metal. And with metal being used, another thing I noticed was the actual overall weight of the Neutronal wand. I mean, like, it's nothing like, you know, too mind-blowing or anything like that, but it certainly feels like, you know, that it's got some girth to it. The metal certainly goes on that. I haven't actually opened it up yet, so I'm not too sure, like, the innards, like, you know, what's actually inside of here to do all of, like, the lights and the vibrations and the electronics and such like that. But once again, this does have a good amount of weight to it. And probably the biggest thing I noticed when I first looked at it was the actual paint app. On the wand here, there are so many small little details. Obviously, this is made to look like the wand that's gonna appear in next year's Ghostbusters Afterlife film. So it's gotta look aged, it's gotta look distressed. The paint effects here make it look like there's actual like metal coming through. And I love like the little details here where it looks like the paint is actually bubbling up a little bit. Once again, little details like that really go a long way in helping this feel like more of a prop replica rather than a toy. Now, another difference here between this wand and the previous released wand is kind of like this little like left side housing here that holds both the intensify and the activate buttons. As you can see here on the Hasbro wand, I mean, this thing looks pretty darn film accurate. But on the one previously released, I mean, they definitely cut some corners here. And comparing the two together here, I mean, it is like a night and day difference. Now, keeping our focus like on the main gun box there, to the right of here, we've got like this like little tube hanging off the side. And what's cool about the Hasbro wand is it's actually like a legit like tube, and it looks to attach exactly how it would attach on the screen used prop. But with the previously released wand that went through MattyCollector.com, everything is just like plastic there. Like even the connectors that like connect to the wand, it's all 100% plastic. Now let's switch gears over to the underbelly of the Neutronal wand. And as you can see, both certainly come with their very own V-hook attached. And for those wondering, it looks like the actual, like the new V-hook there on the Hasbro one, using like legit real screws and everything. So it should be pretty easy to actually remove if you wanted to like change it out and put your own V-hook on it there to, you know, match up to your already pre-existing Proton Pack. Now, a small little detail that really helps the Hasbro one, you know, push ahead even further is the addition here of the S-hook. This was not found on the previous released wand from 2013. And for those out of the know, the S-hook is pretty much used as like a little clip there where if the Ghostbusters want to actually clip the Neutronal wand to their belt, they can certainly do so. So I love the fact that Hasbro included the, once again, that S-hook there. Oh, and actually before I forget, if you guys actually want to learn a story about why the S-hook also exists on the Proton Pack, be sure once again to check out our previous video there where we took a look at the Hasbro Spangler Neutronal wand. Once again, link to that previous video is down below in the description. Click it and yeah, find out the other use for this hook. Now, before I stop talking about the underbelly, going back to the wand released back in 2013, they actually used the underbelly portion of the actual main gun box here as the compartment where you actually stored the batteries inside. The Hasbro wand actually does things a little bit differently. They actually hid their battery compartment inside like the back handle here. All you have to do is unscrew the back cap here. And I gotta say, that's actually quite nice because that means that, you know, if you're at a con or convention or what have you there and you need to change out the batteries ASAP, you don't actually need a screwdriver or anything like that. You can just kind of, once again, untwist it and change out your batteries. But being that we are talking about kind of like that back end, let's actually start talking about the handles. And of course, the biggest change between these two is the one released back in 2013, once again, sold by MattyCollector.com. That one is made to look like a Neutronal wand coming out of Ghostbusters, like the original film or Ghostbusters 2. While the one released by Hasbro, it certainly went through some revisions, some changes. as it's based off of the wand that we're going to see next year in Ghostbusters Afterlife. And I gotta say, the wand on the Hasbro one is actually really comfortable, despite them not really having the standard kind of like, you know, hand grooves and everything like that. They feel nice. I mean, the top one here is kind of like a hard plastic. The one back here is actually more like a, I don't know, like a plastic kind of rubber. It's a little bit softer, it feels like. And I don't want to say that these are like better by any means. It's really going to come down to self-preference, whether or not you prefer like that old school, you know, Neutrona wand look, or you're digging the one that we're going to see once again next year in Ghostbusters Afterlife. But I will say, from like a quality standpoint, I really do enjoy these new handles once again on the Hasbro wand. So now let's focus in on like the front handle here. Actually more so kind of like everything like on the front end of it here, like all the buttons and the banjos. Actually let's first touch on the banjos that are being used here on both of the wands. The one originally sold by MattyCollector.com, it was pretty much all plastic, like the wire and the banjos, everything there were like all the same mold. Heck, even the front trigger ring was part of that same mold, like it was just one big piece of plastic. The front on the Hasbro wand is certainly quite a bit different here, with the banjos being their own separate piece and actually screwed into the wand this time around. Now the banjos are not metal, they are just like a hard plastic, but certainly the quality here is much better overall. Also, the very tip of the Neutrona wand, of course we do have the trigger ring, which does look a little bit different on the Hasbro wand because it's made to obviously look like there has been some wear and tear to it, and everything was just kind of like welded back together in typical, you know, Ghostbusters makeshift fashion. So I do like, once again, that new ring here that's been used on the new Afterlife throwers. Now, if you couldn't tell already, I honestly do feel like the Hasbro wand is better than the one we got back in 2013. I love this wand, and we haven't even gotten into like the electronics side of things as of yet. The only area that I think they could have done a little better on was like the detail up here. As you can see, there's a button here that's not an actual functioning button, and it's also missing a paint app. And comparing that button on the wand released back in 2013, once again, that was non-functioning as well, but they did add a little bit of silver paint to actually make it look like, well, a button. Now before I turn on the Hasbro Spengler Neutrona wand here, I do want to once again say that a lot of these pieces are metal on here, and also a lot of these pieces, like including like the clipper here, is actually just kind of like screwed in, meaning that if you actually wanted to remove some of these pieces, and let's say add your own, you know, more screen accurate prop piece, you can certainly do so, or at least it looks like you should be able to pretty easily. Also, if you missed it in the past video, I talked about how there's actually a different end cap that you can actually add to the back of this wand by, once again, kind of unscrewing it here. And the additional end cap piece, when screwed on, will allow you to attach your very own split loom to it. And that means you could easily attach this Neutrona wand to your very own Proton Pack or a Spirit Halloween Proton Pack. Obviously, there would be some modifications needed here and there, but it can certainly be done crazy, crazy easily. All right, so now it's time to turn on the actual wands here. Let's first start with the one sold by MattyCollector.com. There were three little buttons on it here, and you just kind of do that. Proton Pack is on. Now, one thing I absolutely need to point out when it comes to that wand is as long as those three buttons are up, you can start, you know, firing the proton beam out of the Neutrona wand. Well, I mean, not really firing. You're going to use your imagination, but you know what I mean. You can turn those three buttons on, and you can start blasting with that thrower. The Hasbro wand is a little different here because to get this successfully turned on where you can start, you know, blasting ghosts, you need to actually turn on the two main switches on the gun box first. And after that, that's when you actually hit the activate switch. And I'm going to show you here. I'm going to hit the intensify button and you're going to hear that proton stream. There we go. So proton streams there. Let's turn everything off once again. Now let's go the other way. Let's turn the activate switch first, followed by these two. As you can see, there's no light up here like there was beforehand, and if I hit that intensify button, nothing is happening. Now, in our last video on this one, once again, I talked to Ben Eady, who worked as the Ghostbusters Life armorer on set of Ghostbusters Afterlife, and he did confirm with me that's the actual proper startup sequence to the wand. For the actual prop, if you want to turn this thing on, you need to hit these two first, hit that activate button, and only then you can actually blast the wand. So I love the fact that Hasbro went that extra mile and they actually made this a little bit more accurate to, once again, what we're going to see next year in Ghostbusters Afterlife. Now, upon turning these on, you're going to notice one big thing that the Afterlife one has that the previous release one doesn't. Can you hear that? Like that proton pack hum? Yes, it is included in the Spengler Neutrona wand. And as you can see also, the detail on the bar graphs are also crazy different here. Now, focusing in on the top of the gun box here, we do have very, very similar lights. With really the only big changeup is the Hasbro wand, the actual main lights, like in the middle portion here, have more of like a yellower tinge to them. Which is accurate to what we're going to see in next year's Afterlife film, because the yellow tinge, I'm guessing, is there to obviously make it seem like, you know, it's aged, and like the glass or whatever is kind of like being used as a barrier has also aged, so, you know, it's yellowed. Alright, so the time has now come for me to start firing proton streams, well, at least imaginary proton streams. Right now, I've got the one that was sold on MattyCollector.com in my hand here, and really, if you want to fire it, you hit the intensify button. And nothing is really happening just yet. That is because to shoot this off, I need to actually hit this little green thing right here. The barrel extends, and now I can actually hit the intensify button and fire that proton stream. I don't care what wand it is, I always have a blast firing that proton stream. So let's go ahead and actually turn this off here. Before we do, let's go ahead and make sure we hit this little green button to retract that back in. All right, so we got that turned off. Let's move over to the Hasbro wand now. Okay, so now I've got the Hasbro wand in hand. So let's go ahead and once again, make sure first we switch on the two switches on the gun box. And you can do them in either order. So let's go up and down first. So that's all turned on there. And then let's go ahead and switch on the activate button. And one of the biggest changes here is you can actually fire the actual wand with the barrel still being like within it. In fact, let's go ahead and hit that intensify button. And there we go, we got the proton stream going off there. And once again, the actual barrel is still inside the wand. Now, of course, you're gonna wanna extend that barrel. So to do so, all you have to do is just hit this little green switch here, just pull it back and there we go. There's actually an audio effect when that happens. Let's pop it back in place, there we go. Love that little audio effect. And this also appears to be more of like a spring-loaded kind of design, which to my knowledge is actually more accurate to like the original 1984 Ghostbusters and likely what we're gonna see in Ghostbusters Afterlife. But now that we've got the barrel extended, let's go ahead and blast us a ghost. That is so, so much fun. Now let's go ahead and turn this off. Let's hit the activate button first. Sound effect there. This button, this little switch here kind of handles the lights. And this little switch will also do another audio cue. There we go. So the wand is totally turned off. And one area that is different with this wand compared once again to the one released back in 2013, sold by MattyCollector.com, is that this doesn't actually retract like a self-retraction, meaning that you actually have to push it back into place. Once again, we just heard that audio again. Now, I know some people were complaining about that, but as I discussed with Ben Eady, once again, he was the armorer on set of Ghostbusters Afterlife. If you haven't checked out that video, link down below in the description. That is accurate to what the actual film prop was. They actually had to manually pop it back into place here. So that is 100% accurate to Ghostbusters Afterlife. Now let's actually go back to the proton streams for a quick second, because one thing I forgot to mention was the fact you can actually intensify the stream by kind of turning this like little knob here. So once again, we've got the one that was sold by MattyCollector.com. Let's go ahead and start blasting there. And as you're blasting, if you kind of take this like little circle area right here and you turn it just a little bit, it amplifies the motor inside, the lights go a little quicker, and the rumble is definitely quite a bit louder. Now with the Hasbro wand, let's once again bring that boy in here. Let's flip on all the switches. Let's go ahead and extend that barrel because I love popping that thing out. It's so flipping cool. And let's go ahead and, you know what? No, no. Before we intensify it, let's actually play around with this dial, because see the little meter right here? This will tell you what level you're on when it comes to the overall intensity of the wand here. So let's turn a little bit. You're gonna see, and then we got three little lights there. We got four little lights, and you can actually hear the hum inside the wand get louder and louder. So let's go ahead and go to five. Oh, and you can actually start, yeah, this is definitely rattling a lot more. That hum is so much louder now. And let's go ahead and bust us a ghost. Did you guys see that? That was the overheat sequence from Ghostbusters, the video game. Yes, this Neutrona wand features, well, features from Ghostbusters, the video game. And those features are the upgrades that you can actually get in the game. And to switch to those added upgrades, all you have to do is just hit this little orange button up here. You see that? You see that little green there? That was the slime blower add-on, the slime blower upgrade. And you can hear the slime just churning and oozing inside the wand. In fact, let's go ahead and hit that intensify button and check this out. I absolutely love that. On top of the slime effect, let's go ahead and hit that little orange button again, because now we got the stasis stream, and here you can actually hear the ice crackling inside the wand. Let's go ahead and, once again, hit that intensify button. And coming up last, we've got ourselves, there we go, the Meson Collider. And like, we got that really loud, like high-pitched hum. Let's go ahead and amplify that. Oh man, this thing is shaking like crazy here. Let's, once again, introduce you or reintroduce you to the Meson Collider. And much like the Proton Stream, these three additional effects can also overheat. Now, if I already haven't blown your mind already, with all the features this wand has from Hasbro, let me just seal the deal for you, okay? Let's do, once again, another quick comparison right here for you. The wand sold back in 2013 via MaddieCollector.com. We got it right here. It's a good wand. It's a really good wand. It originally released for $129.99, and since then, the price has, like, skyrocketed on eBay. But once again, keep in mind, $129.99 was the original selling point for this wand. Now let's switch gears over to Hasbro's Neutrona wand. Once again, so many more features found within this wand, so much more detail, so many more things you could do with it if you want to like upgrade it and mod it and such like that. Price on this guy, only $99.99. 30 bucks less than the wand we saw back in 2013. I legit cannot believe they have packed so much value in this wand for such a low price point. Like I just said, $99.99, to me, that is a steal for this wand. And if you want to buy one for your very own, we've got links right down below in the description. Click them and buy your very own Hasbro Spengler Neutrona wand right now. So that does it for today's video, guys. If you would like to actually find out more information about the making of this wand, certainly check out our previous release video where we talked with Ghostbusters Afterlife armorer Ben Eady. He had a hand in helping make this wand. And in that video, we also compare the Hasbro Spengler Neutrona wand up against the actual screen used Afterlife wand. Seriously, if you haven't watched that video, be sure to check it out. Once again, link is right down below in that description. As always, subscribe to Ghostbusters News here on YouTube to stay up to date with all the Ghostbusters happenings. And if you'd like to help support Ghostbusters News, be sure to sign up to the Ghostbusters News Patreon page. Link to that can also be found down below in that description. And I will see everybody right back here next time, Ghostbusters News, right here on YouTube.